Hi, welcome to How to Repair. Today we're going to be showing you how to go into test mode on this Whirlpool Zen 10 kilo washing machine. Now the model number for this machine can be found on the door label, which is an FSCR10432, and the product number, which is also needed with Whirlpool or hot point parts, is 859205915010. This test sequence is basically a one-stop test sequence. Once you enter factory mode or service mode and start the program, it goes all the way through the test procedure. Now, I have not got a full list of all the modern error codes on these machines because for some unknown reason the manual I had did not have the service numbers for each of these F error codes that you can see here, but I will be able to explain to you what it's actually testing during the procedure. I also have a portable test meter here which actually records what is going on with regards to the wattage that is being pulled on the machine. This really does help you to understand things like the heater is working correctly, because it will only show you on the display the actual temperature that the NTC sensor is reading. It will not show you that the heating element is coming on, and this is why I use these portable test meters. They're very cheap to buy, and I'll put a link in the description below for you. Okay, to enter test mode on these machines can be quite complicated. Firstly, make sure the drum is completely empty with no clothing in it. Shut the door. You will need to press the on-off button, and this will illuminate the Night Rider display, as I call it. And you'll understand why for those of you who are of the age that actually saw that TV series. Then you need to worry about button 1 and button 4. You need to press these together, and then holding button 1 down, you need to continue pressing 3 more times on button 4 to enter the test mode procedure. Now, I'm not able to slow this down when filming it because I've got a time scale to actually get into the test mode, but let's try to do this first time. Turning it on, you then get the Night Rider display. And then holding button 1 and 4 as soon as this finishes. 1, 2, 3, 4. It will then enter service mode. You will also be able to turn the dial between factory mode and service mode. Factory mode records the actual error that occurs during the cycle, and service mode will show you the last recorded errors that were on the system. Now, this machine has some error codes already built into it. Okay, I'm quickly going to show you the exploded diagram of this machine so you can understand all the components and where they are. Then we'll be displaying this sheet here for you to follow while it runs through the test procedure, as I have a limited amount of time for to explain all the functions while it's going through the test procedure. So let me quickly explain. There are 6 tests, and it will be going from C0, which is checking the door lock, the program, and looking for all these error codes that may appear. C1 will be testing the water fill system, and this can vary on many different machines because you may have a washer dryer or you may have a machine with a hot valve fitted. So it's checking all the solenoids to make sure that they're letting water into the correct compartments. It will then transfer the information of the level of water that's in the machine via the pressure bowl, which pressurizes and sends the information to the pressure switch of how much water is in the drum. This is measured in Hertz frequency. This data will then be transferred to the computer, which then will be able to detect the amount of water that's in the machine. C2 will then measure the temperature of the water that's in the machine, and it will also activate the heating element. And you want to look closely at this meter so you can actually see that the heating element is being turned on and is actually drawing power, because it only tests it for 5 to 10 seconds. C3 will then activate the circulation pump if fitted on the machine, and then it will switch over to empty the machine of any water that is in the machine. C4 will then be testing the imbalance load sensor and also doing a full motor RPM test on the motor itself, and it will measure if there is any imbalance on the machine, and it will display the actual kilograms or grams of imbalance on the display, and the drain pump will still be active at this point. C5, it turns everything off until the motor stops spinning, then it will energize the door lock, allowing you to gain access to the machine, and then it will turn the machine off. Okay, let's enter test mode. Again, pressing the on-off button, waiting for the display to come up. I find this the easiest way to enter diagnostic mode right at the beginning. 1, 2, 3, 4. We've entered service mode. As I said, you can flick between factory and service mode. We're just going to deal with service mode. Pressing the button once, and we've got an F25 error code. It will record the last two error codes, I believe, because if I press it again, F25 will still show up, but if there was two error codes present, then it would show another error code recording the last two. So I'm going to press this again. As you can see, nothing's changed. I'm going to press it again. One more time, and we've now, door lock is activated. It's doing the CPU test, and it's moved on to C1. C1 is testing the water coming into the machine on one water valve, and then it will flick over after 6 seconds to another water valve. You can see the drum is rotating in a clockwise and then an anti-clockwise rotation, and this should be roughly turning at 45 to 50 RPM. This will continue testing the water valves until it moves through to C02, which is done. The heater is now activated, and we've got a temperature of 11 centigrade of water coming into the machine. It will continue going through here until it activates C03, which is the recirculation pump. You want to be looking inside the drum, and you will see water trickling down the glass. This means that the circulation pump is active, and the motor will actually rotate in one direction in a second, but you can hear the main pump has been activated and the water is being emptied from the machine. It will then start doing a rotation, and then it will move into C4. Motor just moved, and now we're going into an anti-clockwise rotation. And now I've got a little bit of time, because this will take about 2-3 minutes to go through the whole test sequence on C4. And this will build up to the maximum RPM of the machine. On this machine, it's 1400 RPM. Excuse me. So at some point during the cycle, it will actually show us a weight on the screen here. So do keep an eye at this point. But the machine now is building up in RPM. It doesn't show us what speed it's doing. It will just gradually build all the way up to 1400 RPM. And there we go. We've got 0.01 kg of imbalance. It now moves on to the maximum RPM test of the motor. And once it's finished testing that, it will then move on to C5, where it turns the machine off. Now, I've got a little bit of time to talk about what goes on these machines. You'll notice there's quite a bit of rust on these. I've seen this on many occasions on these machines. For some unknown reason, if you do not have the water pressure set up correctly, and also the fill system, or the water going to the machine, is not at the correct amount of bars, you end up with leaks appearing, and this causes a lot of corrosion on the front of these panels. These machines are quite quiet, they're well built. The actual test functionality is pretty good on these machines, quite difficult to get into, but But what I don't like is I haven't been able to give you all the F error codes. And I would appreciate any Whirlpool engineer using the product code that you've got on the display here to be able to help other people out in the future and put a full list of what all the F0 error codes are. Because I had F39 on this and it doesn't even show up in the test sequence. I believe I may have a CPU problem with this machine because that did come up on one occasion, but now this machine is coming up with an F25 error code and that's not actually on the display either. This machine is actually going to be recycled for parts once I finished making a couple of videos on it, for the simple reason the amount of corrosion here and at the bottom of the machine is pretty bad and it's not worth reselling the machine or even giving it to someone because of the actual faults that are occurring on the CPU. But they are quite a quiet machine and quite a good machine really, apart from this fill problem which I believe a lot of the machines have. But this should run for about another 30 seconds or so, and then it will move into C05, which actually turns the power off on the motor. There we go. And now that will let the motor stop completely before it activates the door lock. So we'll just let this shut down. As you can hear, the pump is still running. The motor has stopped. Pump stops, you heard the click, shut the power off to the machine and the door can be opened. And there you go, that's the test procedure for this machine. I do apologize to you that I did not have all the F error codes for you at the time of filming, but as we get them, we will put them in the comments below. I hope this helped you. Please remember, if you do need any parts for this machine, use the website. It's much appreciated to support the website as that's what keeps us going and able to make these videos for you. And if we really helped you, you can always click on the Bipolar Beer page, which donates to the website to support the website. Thanks very much indeed for watching.